party and our partners in the NDA are poised for a huge victory in the elections. The BJP and its partners will get a two-third majority in India. The very fact that the Congress president is afraid of defeat in Amethi, which is their backyard of so many years, and has to run all the way to Wayanad, and there also he has to fight against his own partner, the CPM. And then CPM complains, he says, I will not say a word against CPM. Then what are you fighting for? How will you fight an election without saying a word against your opponent? It clearly shows the Congress party president has lost the confidence of the people of India. He is today a person who has no popularity. He has lost the confidence and is forced to come all the way to Kerala. I am sure the people of Kerala will defeat Rahul Gandhi in Wayanad, so that next election he will have to look for a constituency in some other country to fight the election.
How far BJP will fare in Kerala?
We are very confident of a spectacular victory in Kerala. We are receiving huge support in every city, every constituency that we are going. We expect the results in Kerala, in West Bengal, in Odisha, in the Northeast. States where we did not do too well will all give spectacular results in this election. They are all looking for a development-oriented government. They are all wanting an honest government. They are all wanting a strong leader like Prime Minister Narendra Modi, who will protect the country, who will keep the life of every Indian safe and secure, who will bring peace and harmony to Kerala, who will bring respect for the people's faith, culture, tradition, heritage, history back to Kerala, who will promote tourism in Kerala, who will give a better future to the youth and women of Kerala, who will ensure the well-being of every farmer and fisherman in Kerala. There is only one leader, Narendra Modi, who will bring all-round good development and corruption-free government to Kerala. Well, I think those comments were taken out of context, and I do not believe Yogi Adityanath ji or Maneka Gandhi ji made a comment which was against the spirit of the Model Code of Conduct. But we respect the Honorable Election Commission, and we are following the guidelines of the Election Commission. Having said that, we also believe that the faith of the people of India has to be respected. If the opposing parties do not respect the faith of the people of India, then in the heat of the moment, our leader had to make a comment. But at the same time, if all parties maintain decorum and do not polarize the election.
What is your take on Azam Khan and Mayawati?
Clearly what Mr. Azam Khan said was derogatory to the women of India. It was shameful, and he has not even expressed regret for his comments. It is the worst form of discrimination against our sisters and mothers, and I completely condemn Mr. Azam Khan for his comments.
Sir, Mamata Banerjee has brought Bangladesh and Bengal.
Because she has already lost the faith and support of the people of West Bengal. Defeat is staring her in the face, and she knows that the people of Pashchim Bengal, West Bengal, will not make the mistake of electing her party again. Therefore, she has to now look at clutches from across the border.
Sir, lastly, what is your
take? Thank you, sir. You came and you explained everything here.